Hello, vital sign. Today we're going to cover Cartesian products of graphs. To review, a Cartesian product of two sets, A and B, is the set of all ordered pairs, AB, where B is in set B and A is in set A. For example, the Cartesian product of the set 1, 2, and 3, 4, 5 is this. 1, 3, 2, 3, 1, 4, 2, 4, 1, 5, and 2, 5. Where each element of the Cartesian product is an ordered pair of elements from the sets 1, 2, and 3, 4, 5. This also shows that the Cartesian product of two sets A and B has a size equal to the product of the sizes of sets A and B. Set A in this case had two elements and set B had three elements. So the Cartesian product has six elements. So how do we take a Cartesian product of graphs? Well, just like the Cartesian product of two sets is itself a set, the Cartesian product of two graphs G and H is itself a graph. Remember that a graph is really a set of vertices and a set of edges between those vertices. Keeping that in mind, here's the definition of the Cartesian product of graphs. The Cartesian product of two graphs, G and H, where G has vertex set A with n vertices and graph H has vertex set B with k vertices, is a graph with a set of vertices equal to the Cartesian product of the vertex sets of graphs G and H, with each vertex in the Cartesian product graph representing a pair of one vertex from graph G and one vertex from graph H. Here's an example. If graph G's vertex set A was this, and graph H's vertex set B was this, the vertex set of their Cartesian product would be this. Note that due to the properties of the Cartesian product, the Cartesian product graph will have as many vertices as the product of the number of vertices of its factor graphs. We define the connections between vertices in the Cartesian product graph as follows. Suppose we have two vertices in the Cartesian product of graphs G and H. Let's call these vertices U, V, and U prime, V prime, where U and U prime are vertices from graph G, and V prime are vertices from graph H. These two vertices are adjacent if they satisfy either of these two rules. Either U equals U prime in graph G, that is, they are the same vertex in graph G, and V prime are connected in graph H, or if V equals V prime in graph H, that is, they are the same vertex in graph H, and U prime are connected in graph G. To really understand what's going on, we'll need to work through some examples. Let's find the Cartesian product of a cycle graph of four vertices and a graph of a single vertex. For clarity's sake, I have labeled the vertices of graph G on the left with letters and the vertices of graph H on the right with numbers, so it's clear what graph a vertex belongs to. The first thing we need to do is determine the vertex set of the Cartesian product graph. To do that, we'll need to list out the vertex sets of each graph and take the Cartesian product of those vertex sets. The vertex set of graph G is A, B, C, D. And the vertex set of graph H is 1. Their Cartesian product gives us A1, B1, C1, and D1 as the set of vertices in the Cartesian product graph. The next thing to do is determine the adjacencies of the vertices in our Cartesian product. Here are our adjacency rules. Since we only have one vertex in the right graph, graph H, the only adjacency rule that matters is the second one, that states two vertices in the Cartesian product are connected if V equals V prime and if U is adjacent to U prime in graph G. Again, this is because the Cartesian product tells us to connect vertices where the left entries are the same vertex in graph G and the right entries are different but adjacent vertices in graph H, or connect vertices where the right entries are the same vertex in graph H and the left entries are different but adjacent vertices in their graph G. That means that in this case, we're looking for vertices whose left entries or letters are adjacent in graph G, as their right entries are already the same vertex in graph H. Vertex A1 must be adjacent to vertex B1, because vertex A is adjacent to vertex B in graph G, and vertex 1 equals vertex 1 in graph H. Vertex B1 must be adjacent to vertex C1 and to vertex A1, because vertex B is adjacent to vertices C and A in graph G, and vertex 1 is equal to vertex 1 in graph H. Two more to go. Vertex C1 must be adjacent to vertex D1 and to vertex B1, because vertex C is adjacent to vertices B and D in graph G, and vertex 1 equals vertex 1 in graph H. Finally, vertex D1 must be adjacent to vertex A1 and C1, because vertices C and A are adjacent to vertex D in graph G, and vertex 1 equals vertex 1 in graph H. We're done. That's the Cartesian product graph. Notice that it is just a copy of the graph on the left, graph G. The intuition behind the adjacency rules is this. The first adjacency rule creates adjacencies in the Cartesian product based upon adjacencies in the right graph, graph H. And the second adjacency rule creates adjacencies in the Cartesian product according to adjacencies in the left graph, or graph G. Since we only had a single vertex in the right graph, graph H, there were no adjacencies to account for in the right graph, and so we only needed to use the second adjacency rule. Let's try one more example. What happens if we take the Cartesian product of a path graph of 4 vertices and a path graph of 2 vertices? The first thing to do is take the Cartesian product of the vertex sets A, B, C, D, and 1, 2. Feel free to pause the video and work this out yourself. Okay, now we need to find out which Cartesian product vertices are adjacent to which other Cartesian product vertices. We'll need to use both adjacency rules for this product. What vertex is A1 connected to? Well, remember a rule from before. In this case, A is U and 1 is V. Our first condition says that if U equals U prime, and V is adjacent to V prime, then the two vertices connect. In this case, that would mean asking for another vertex where the left entry on its ordered pair is A, so that U equals U prime, and where the right entry is a vertex adjacent to vertex 1. Looks like vertex A2 is perfect, as A equals A in the left graph, and 1 is adjacent to 2 in the right graph. According to the same logic, we could connect vertices B1 to B2, C1 to C2, and D1 to D2. Now for our second condition, where V equals V prime and U is adjacent to U prime. Starting again with A1, we would be asking for another vertex where the right entry on its ordered pair is 1 and the left entry is a vertex adjacent to vertex A. Looks like B1 is what we're looking for, as the right entries are the same and the left entries are adjacent in the left graph. Applying the same logic, the second adjacency rule, we can connect B1 to C1 and C1 to D1. We can also connect A2 to B2, B2 to C2, and C2 to D2. All done. This is the Cartesian product of a path graph of 4 vertices and a path graph of 2 vertices. Notice how the Cartesian product is really two path graphs of 4 vertices linked together. Two copies linked together is the pattern that arises when we take the product of a path graph of length 2 with any other graph. If we take the product of a cycle graph of 4 vertices with a path graph of 2 vertices, we get a prism. Feel free to pause the video and think about why this is true due to our adjacency rules. This is because we're taking the product of a cycle graph of 4 vertices with a path graph of 2 vertices, producing two copies according to the second adjacency rule. The two copies are linked together by the first adjacency rule. Think of it this way. Each vertex on the right graph copies the left graph because of the second adjacency rule. And then the adjacencies in the right graph tell us how to connect those copies to each other through the first adjacency rule. Another example of this behavior would be that the Cartesian product of two path graphs is a grid graph. Why? Say we have two path graphs of length 4, and we're going to find their Cartesian product. We're going to copy the path graph 4 times according to the second adjacency rule. Then we're going to link each copy together according to the first adjacency rule. That is the intuition behind the Cartesian product, copying the left graph through the second adjacency rule, and then linking those copies together in some way through the first adjacency rule. In my next video, I'll show you how we can use the Cartesian product to define a graph that captures the legal moves of a rook on a chessboard. And in future videos in this series, we'll cover other graph operations, like the strong product and the tensor product. That's all for this video. Thanks for watching. Please subscribe, like, share, and let me know if you have any questions in the comments. Have a great day.